First and foremost, it's always most important to protect the plants in their natural habitat. But sometimes that's not enough. And that's where places like the Arnold Arboretum and other botanical gardens come into play. The Arnold Arboretum was founded in 1872 as Harvard's Tree Museum. We're a beloved Boston park that was designed by Frederick Law Olmsted, where we have over 1.5 million people visiting every single year. Throughout our 281-acre landscape, we've got around 16,000 trees, shrubs, and vines that we've collected from around the world. And we do this for conservation, for research, for teaching, and of course, for the public enjoyment. The Arnold Arboretum is a wonderful platform for research. We've got on top of 75 to 100 research projects a year, studying everything from the big picture effects of global change, climate change, extra CO2 in our atmosphere, all the way down to how roots of trees interact with mycorrhizal fungi in order to fix nitrogen. But right now, about 38% of trees on Earth are threatened with extinction. And that's due to a number of different causes, from loss of habitat, invasive species, pest, pathogen, and the effects of a climate that's out of whack. These are living pieces of art. It's constantly under change. And so we lean into that dynamism. And so we're preparing for what do we plant for next year? What do we plan to plant in decade to come or decades to come? And so through our strategic planning initiatives, we launched about a decade ago a campaign for the living collections, a strategic plan for plant acquisition, plant exploration around the world to acquire tree, shrubs, and vines that are threatened with extinction, those that might be better prepared to grow in our newly changed ecosystem known as Boston. And so we're constantly preparing for what might be the collection of the future.